is pure theater.
Back. Fighters ready? Ready? Fight!
And Istela Nunes has shown us that she is here to stick around and do some damage while she does. And she starts this first round pretty much as she did, sorry, this second round pretty much as she did the first, with good hands. And Angela Lee will have to be very careful of that overhand right from Nunes, and that landed right on the button.
Istela Nunes survived the worst possible scenario. That has to have her confidence really high heading into this second round with the champion.
And remember, as Nunes sets up this attack with her fists, her real power comes from her legs. She can kick up to the head with devastating results. And Angela Lee will be mindful of that.
See, immediately Angela Lee is cutting off the angles, trying to get her pressed up against the cage. Typically, Angela doesn't like to shoot for a lot of takedowns. She gets most of her takedowns from the clinch position. So that's what Nunes has to be careful of in this next round.
It's quite clear that Angela wants the full contact. She wants to get in there close and nullify the attack that Nunes can provide in the stand-up.
The kick, went for the takedown, and delivered a knee as she was pinned up against the cage there.
More knees to the head. Istela gets up on her feet, though. Angela tries to pull her down.
She's got her in a darce choke position, one hand under the neck, the other hand laced under her arm. She's trying to snap her down, goes for the outside trip. That's an anaconda choke, Steve. Collapses beautifully in the anaconda. That's tight.
She's saying she's okay. She's giving Olivier Coste the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance again from Istela Nunes.
Right there, she has to frame off her hands, create a little bit of space with that right arm. So the arm is, she's essentially getting choked with her own arm.
She's still giving Olivier the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance from the Brazilian, but Angela Lee's attack is furious.
Look at Nunes, her head is pressed up against the side there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee has both arms nice and tight, but there is space for Nunes to breathe. Her right arm is not completely tight to her back.
I think she's done it. She's done it. It couldn't last forever. Angela Lee has made her second successful defense of a world title. The tears are already falling. She's done it again. The roar around me at the Singapore Indoor Stadium is deafening. Into the arms of her father, Ken Lee, who's coached her since she was a young girl. And the emotion is evident for all to see. The resistance from Istela Nunes was strong. And right up until the very final moment, it looked like it was going to continue. But there's the relief. A picture for all of Singapore to look at and be proud. Christian Lee, her brother, giving her a hug. Mitch, take us through these final moments. Rich Franklin is with us as well. Rich, just take us through these final moments.
I tell you, it's just to watch Angela Lee do this. I mean, she's been able to pull off an anaconda, a twister, guillotine chokes, arm bars. It's crazy. And you know, you saw her prior to this actually working the snap down, trying to earn that takedown. And then she was set in this kind of anaconda choke position from the standing position the whole time and ended up working it to the trip where she earned that position. It's just amazing to see the different angles that she's able to work various submissions from. She's always looking for something.
Well, Dom Lau has the official decision, and you can bet that it is going to be met with rapturous cheers from the crowd here in Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this bout, we have Mr. Roger Chen, GoDaddy's Vice President of Asia. And now, your referee, Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of anaconda choke, and still one women's atomweight champion of the world, unstoppable Angela Lee!
Istela Nunes falls to 5-1. The champion Angela Lee improves to 8-0. She screams at the camera. Victor Kui has the honor of putting that belt around her waist. She retains her title. The confetti comes down from the skies. We're drenched in it here at Cageside and are happy to be so. It's been a wonderful night's entertainment. That's Muhammad Ali. And that is Aung La N Sang.
You ready? 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 Go!
This fight brought to you by AGD Bank, our main event of the evening. The crowd here, by far the noisiest they've been all night, and they've participated all evening long.
Aung La N Sang knows that he gets overexcited, and he's trying to calm down and really have his composure, not get utilize his game planned. He's, you know, he's got too excited in fights before, and it's cost him the bout. So this time he really wants to settle down, calm himself, not get overexcited by this crazy atmosphere that's here, and control the fight.
It's Muhammad Ali who wants to make the quicker start. Aung La N Sang does look pretty calm. Boxing closed mouth, thunderous left hand, but it's caught by Muhammad Ali.
You wouldn't think that Muhammad Ali would want this fight to go to the ground. He's a little bit tentative to engage.
Reluctant. Yes, so Yuji sees that. Ooh. Now Yuji called him to stand up. Muhammad Ali changed his mind, but it's too late by that time. Up they get. Fighting out of the southpaw stance there. Aung La N Sang switches occasionally.
Muhammad Ali is just coming in with big shots.
Both hands landing, the right hand going upstairs, the knee coming back, but it's the busy right hand of Muhammad Ali that's doing all the work there in the stand-up.
It's a dirty boxing style. He just kind of grabs the back of Aung La N Sang's head and starts throwing those uppercuts and hooks. This is what Aung La N Sang's got to kind of slow everything down, really gauge control of this fight, and he's trying to use that outside trip. Nice little technique.
Drags him down. Muhammad Ali to his knees. But then Ali goes for the single leg.
Now, Aung La N Sang, we need to see what Aung La N Sang's like off of his back. This is Muhammad Ali really trying to hand fight there, control the hands. Nice little butterfly sleep. We've seen this before.
Crowd making rapturous noise here at the Tuana Stadium.
We've seen that same move before, that same butterfly sweep, but Muhammad Ali was able to roll, continuously roll out of it and get out of that position.
Switches to orthodox, Aung La N Sang, as the crowd's noise rings in his ears. Again, Muhammad Ali goes for the single leg.
Oh, there's a possible guillotine, it's deep.
It's tapped out.
By submission, via guillotine choke, Aung La N Sang!
There's the picture that will be on the front page of the newspapers in this country tomorrow morning. Victor Kui giving his congratulations to our winner.
Singapore on the edge of their seats. This one brought to you by Global Citizen. Left hook there from Ting. Outside leg kick from Ting. Good punch there. Now the human highlight reel would love. World champion.
Good job by Ting, get up on top, but a beautiful sweep there by Abe. Used that Kimura trap to pull himself over. Now he's got the headlock. Ting's trying to work his way to the back. Good job by Ting, almost dumping out the ring ropes here. He's got the back though of Abe. He's got that triangle, locked up that leg. It's gonna be hard to restart that position. I think that's why the referee's letting him work a little bit.
Back elbows there from Daichi Abe. Referee trying to get them away from that bottom rope. Good work there.
Yeah, I don't think the referee wanted to break that. He realizes what a possible problem that's going to be to restart that. Good job by Ting to maintain that top position. Ground and pound coming.
Back to their feet in the corner here.
Good job by Abe to work his way back up to his feet. Now he's got that leg in between the legs of Ting. Good balance shown by Abe.
3:25 remains, second round of three. Stellar contest here in the ONE Championship lightweight division. Snappy jab from Daichi Abe, the Pancrase World Welterweight Champion. I've been trade jab. Overhand right, Abe.
You can see those awkward trips of Abe as he tries to step in, utilize those judo trips on Ting. Ting's tried to figure it out so far, and he's starting to have a little more success in creating that base.
And a great night so far for Malaysia. Big win for Gian Ratsuan earlier on over Joe Marie Torres. They'll bring the house down again if Ting can defeat Daichi Abe here. Yeah. Over from Ting, going for the headache maker. Big outside leg kick.
You can see the way Ting throws that overhand right. He's really dropping his head down to commit a lot more power to that overhand right. But he's got to be careful. If Abe can see it coming and time it correctly with an uppercut, he might send Ting time traveling.
Choke, Ting!
Malaysia. They are going crazy for Ting. And why not? That's why they call him the human highlight reel.
That is
the perfect word, sold out. Not one empty seat inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. This has been an amazing third and final. Shut down on Yodsanklai in the third. Yod rallied back in the second. Looked like he may have come close to dropping Sana, but it didn't happen for the tie. And here they go toe-to-toe again. You get flashes of 2001 in Fukuoka, Mark Hunt versus Ray Seppo in an all-time K1 classic. We're seeing the makings of an all-time one Super Series classic. Body shot from Yodsanklai, step up knee from Samy Sana. Yod tries to force him back with the hands.
You can see Sana's trying to... Oh, he caught him with a big right hand off the kick. Now Yod on it.
Yodsanklai feels it. Now Yodsanklai. Here comes Samy Sana. Samy Sana can sniff it. He can sense it. He can smell it. Yodsanklai might be right for the pickings. And referee Delops is cautioning Samy Sana.
Can't clinch. That's what he's warning him of. You can see Sana was trying to get in there, but he was just letting those close-range strikes go.
Yod goes to the body. He's taking far too much head punishment, though, Yodsanklai. He's got to be smart now. He's got to understand why they call in the boxing computer. You've got to think about it, Yod. You can't stand in that phone booth and let Samy Sana rain up punches on you. Body shot from Yod. Knee there from Samy Sana. A tremendous battle of attrition. This is when you've got to dig deep. This is when it's more than kicks, more than punches. It's guts. It's intestinal fortitude. It's that Bushido spirit, Mitch.
Man, they are just trained. You can see the Yod's coming. There's just a bunch of
flying. Flying.
I had to pause because I saw it fly.
Hell taste my feet.
Oh, my God. Just eating these shots, Michael.
And Yodsanklai rallies back. Samy Sana has hit him with some absolute anvils. The uppercut from Samy Sana.
This could be a giant upset by a lot if Samy Sana is able to pour it on here the last 60 seconds of the match.
Sana said he could do it. He said he had the keys to unlock the riddle of Yodsanklai. Rocks the head back again.
Stop! Right.
And there's no defense. They're just catching all the punches with their face.
Yodsanklai goes to the jaw of Sana. A right hand from Sana. A step through knee again. Sana comes forward, locks up Yod, and referee Delopsis breaks them. 45 seconds remains. Throws the knee again. Yod's got to go to work now. He's got to put the foot down. Pull out all the stops. Caution to the wind. It's time for Yod to go. But has he got it in the tank, the veteran?
30 seconds left in the final round.
Yodsanklai, so many people's overwhelming favorite removed from this tournament. Stop. Are we going to see him eliminated at the hand, the knee, the kicks of Samy Sana? The right hand again from Sana. Yodsanklai trying to get through, trying for the knockout punch, the knockout roundhouse kick, but it's not coming forward. And there it is. There it is. Who will advance to the semi-final round?
You can see one Super Series athlete, Benny Zatun, celebrating in the corner like his boy came away with the victory, and Sana jumps up into the corner. We gotta see some highlights of that round because it was filled with them over and over, just going toe to toe. You could have tied these two together because there was no movement, just standing in front of him. Look at that, sucking on the heel of the foot there from Samy Sana. But then Sana still comes back. Look how he takes it on the arm, tries to parry it to Ray, and then just comes straight down the middle with a huge right hand from Samy Sana.
From the blue corner,
it's the upset.
Samy Sana.
Samy Sana said he had the keys to unlock the riddle of Yodsanklai, and indeed he did just that. So many people's favorite.